Do we have anything like that in the works?
A moment, please, Mr. President.
Under the authority granted me as Director of Weapons Research and Development, I commissioned last year a study of this project by the Bland Corporation. Based on the findings of the report, my conclusion was that this idea was not a practical deterrent for reasons which at this moment must be all too obvious.
Then you mean it is possible for them to have built such a thing?
Mr. President, the technology required is easily within the means of even the smallest nuclear power. It requires only the will to do so.
But how is it possible for this thing to be triggered automatically and at the same time impossible to untrigger?
Mr. President, it is not only possible, it is essential. That is the whole idea of this machine, you know. Deterrence is the art of producing in the mind of the enemy the fear to attack. And so, because of the automated and irrevocable decision-making process which rules out human meddling, the doomsday machine is terrifying. It's simple to understand and completely credible and convincing.
Gee, I wish we had one of them doomsday machines, Stacy.
But this is fantastic, Strangelove. How can it be triggered automatically?
Well, it's remarkably simple to do that. When you merely wish to bury bombs, there's no limit to the size. After that, they are connected to a gigantic complex of computers. Now then, a specific and clearly defined set of circumstances under which the bombs are to be exploded is programmed into a tape memory bank. A single roll of
Strangler
can store all the information.
What kind of a name is that? That ain't no crowd name, is it, Stanley? He changed it when he became a citizen. It used to be McVictor Lieber. A crowd by any other name, I think.
Is that the whole point of the doomsday machine is lost?
If you keep it a secret, why didn't you tell the world, eh?